is in the middle of singular satisfactory DTC for a while, but nobody in the room spoke French, so they assumed I spoke fluent French and said, great, you have to come.
I didn't know he didn't speak French because he said, yes, I speak French. I think it's very important to react to lie and lie. So it doesn't get you parched. You just don't lie about you can swim when you can't, because that wouldn't be smart. But I mean, it was an innocuous little white lie. He said he spoke fluent French, and he gave me a line of dialogue in French. I was so impressed. And I loved him in Midnight Cowboy and some of the things he had done. He always put his kind of quirky parts. And yet I wanted him to play against type and to play a cartographer who also speaks French and is inducted into the governmental ranks to be Truffaut's interpreter. And I also saw a kind of kinship between Truffaut and Balaban. And when I put Balaban's picture on my little casting board next to Truffaut's, they almost looked like French partners and soulmates.
Il s'agit d'un petit groupe de gens,
this is a
small group of people, qui ont eu la même vision en même temps,
who have shared a vision in common.
My main reason for casting François, and it was a pipe dream, everybody has their wish list. You know, you put the impossible dream at the top of the list and you work your way down to the more practical choices. And he was at the very top of my list, but mainly because I had seen him in Wild Child, and I felt he was such a tremendous human presence in that film. He just radiated so much compassion. And I felt that rather than putting the face of government on this movie, the face of bureaucracy on the characters who are on the government side, I wanted to put the image of government on all the vehicles and all the bureaucracy. But I wanted the face that led the way to be extremely charitable and kind and optimistic. And Truffaut came into my mind like a snap of a finger. I remember calling him and getting him on the phone in Paris, and through his assistant who spoke English, he interpreted for us. I asked him if he would read my script that I had written myself. And he was impressed the fact that I had written the script myself. I wasn't directed, because he'd written so many of his own scripts. And he said, yes, please send it to me, which was in English, by the way. And I sent him the script, and 2 days later I got a telegram where he said, please send somebody over to talk about my wardrobe. That was sort of contained in the telegram. That was the way he said yes.
I remember being told one day that François Truffaut was going to play the part of the doctor. And the whole movie took a notch up, you know. Steven took a notch up. The studio took a notch up. Because he was so, and is so, extraordinary figure. It said something amazing and reconfirming about our attitude of what Close Encounters was all about. If Close Encounters just a science fiction movie, François Truffaut never would have done that. But he also recognized the noble ambition of that film, that's why he said yes.
I think that François Truffaut, for the mass market audience in the United States, was not well known because French films in French had never had an easy time with it, and there always are French places. But the large number of people who did know who he was were awesome, basically, as was everybody on the movie. I mean, Richard certainly loves Dreyfus, and I know when they all met him, they all would come to me and say, you know, like, we're scared, you know, what's happening? He's really nice guys, you know, don't be afraid, he doesn't speak English, so he's going to seem kind of stern and nervous, but it's just because he doesn't speak, but he really likes you all. I was kind of like translating back and forth.
He only thought and dreamed and lived about films, before. And so that's all, everything that he talked about, the behavior on the set, what producers should and should not say to crew members, what this should happen, what that should. I mean, he had everything down in terms of movies. He did what?
I know François Truffaut went up to Steven in the beginning of the movie and made it very clear. He said, you know, I'm here to be an actor in this movie. I'm not a director. You just tell me what to do, sir, and I'll do anything you say. And it was completely like that during the movie.
He loved the idea of working for Steven. He was so happy to be there because he had a job, and this was such a great, energetic movie, and he had such great things to say about everybody. And he was completely in love with this, you know, filmmaker. And he was just completely soaked in it. That's what it was like about that. I remember I was in a very, very, when I was a dancer, in a very, very obscure movie called Redline 7000. And I was telling him about it. He says, I know it's a movie. It was Howard Hawks' last movie. It had James Caan. It had so-and-so. It had so-and-so. He knew everybody in it. I was a singing waitress in it. I know the scene that you are in. It has a building to fake French. It had the building. He knew everything. He was steeped in it, like I was. I said, you know, don't you ever sleep? And you just watch TV and movies all the time. And that's what it did.
François Truffaut was
already famous for his admiration of children, and I was no exception. I remember him being very affectionate, just very kind and very loving.
So he's vulnerable. Come on, Jesus.
His stature, basically, the kids, he was like, you know, taking up that ability to just look at somebody and say, if they're friendly and if they're kid friendly, they knew about it. He was like the Pied Piper. I'm not certain that 2001 inspired me more than that it intimidated me, because it was such a great movie. Of course, you know, one of the impressions about 2001 was amazing visual effects, and I got the list of everybody responsible for it. And of all the people whose names were credited, the one person who lived in Los Angeles was Bud Crummel. The rest of them were British. And Cullen was in Los Angeles also. I remember Cullen was one of the first people I ever met, Cullen Gatwell. And Cullen did the very, very first CGI test in history for Close Encounters. And actually, our computer generated three flying discs with lights flying across a football stadium, all computer generated. It might have been the first for a movie computer generated test ever done. And it was extraordinary, but it still wasn't up to the